Here we are also with Martin.
So just to you, which is Ida from
online. Here panelists are ready. Of this workshop, hub for business input. If you its common principles, you are going to go off here.
And what will government new issues? I hope this session and protect our will join us today. Who is a global policy. Shishida, New York, I apologize. At the same that there's a heat. Milo and initiate. So is the Rossini and the as you there's something that we are about is the data flow. So and this the societies. So, Carolina.
Schmack. Put this. Around data flow in a related panel around internet fragmentation and how core elements but talk different measures data with trust and measures, but in terms of sheer volume, data produced worldwide by 2025, and that's just one example of a statistic. In those CDs that we used to have when we were a little bit younger, that chain of CDs would circle the Earth over 200 times. So things, if you think about agriculture, health, manufacturing, environment, and transportation. And a trustworthy access and a rights respecting access. Both, if you think about data, has a core. Actually, to improve all the economic sectors and collectively fight a global challenge such as global. How even should they track the effectiveness of understand why data is unique. I have a couple of messages here and then data, especially data care. New currency, we've heard actually to start approaching a familiar situation to literally to make real policy choice. Growing and diverse. The number of aid to the number of another resource I want to share is our data governance atlas, where we mapped almost 300 organizations working this matters.
It's governments similarly risk all. As we see sporadic reflected in the concerns are often focused on U.S. government access, and that's why I spend much of my time working on Microsoft, and specifically laws such as Cloud Act and FISA. But increasingly, there is recognition that many countries around the world have broad laws on paper that may be used to compel technology providers to produce certain customer data, including personal data. However, the fear here is largely theoretical, based on, in our view, my view, on mistaken notions of mass or systemic surveillance across borders. The reality is much different. Belonging to a non-US based enterprise. Where we my intervention just by noting that
access and how the data flow. The economy for resource which we have to take care about, and you touched upon the government access as well. So, which is the graphics of the the government will take some country is thinking that the country and government is the primary stakeholders in the governing the data governance. Private sector and the environmental debates here. Session. So thank you, you two. Just raising the flags to so what is it? This access we
but are going to sign up to access to two countries that sign up to these trusted government come up with. And the first one we think that and we have across all of them. That's really certainty. Yeah, we've got a clear and comprehensive sort of SREMs related in terms of for access to that data or public data by governments. And to prohibit unfair and discriminatory treatment. That's okay. That's raised by the SREMS case. But also, obviously, access to that data is restricted to infringement of people's privacy rights is proportionate to what they're actually trying. In most cases, some prior judicial approval before there are going to be some cases. And situations, and I guess you would expect the authorities to be very quickly be able to use locations that governments need approval in be any unlawful or disproportionate access to data. In Europe, where at the moment most extraterritorial. Challenges where there are the right, and you don't have the constitutional protection as a US citizen in the US. Difference in laws and international agreements that minimize those conflicts of law. Also, yes, that is operating. So that companies are not, and individuals are not caught in the middle. So that's a sort of the eight principles. But why do I think it's important for business? One of the order. Determinations as to in place country. It's incredibly challenging for governments to come up is by the friction in the free flow of data and digital economies.
The guidance for the access quite important personal data protection now countries' personal data will matters in the private sector. So, Gregory, please take floor.
To step back a little bit and to think access to data to personal data, to data in very sensitive communications between two individuals. It's very easy to say, oh, activity. Your be particular circumstances. Processes underway which makes it later. Put into the materials to communication surveillance is because that's an effort group of NGOs and eventually signed on to by 600 around the world. I'm going to put a link to them in the chat right now. But I want to drill down on a couple of them that I think are particularly important. The first is the role of judicial authorities. Level. That reflects a strong probability of aspect that I wanted to draw. The first is the demands were reported without substantial risk to national very low. There is some risk, I have to acknowledge that, that there will be information that could be used. The other aspect of transparency that I want to stress was user notification. Unlawful. It's a crime. And I think the approach ought to be the opposite. And I think that in any case, let me stop. Particularly when we
actually, it is a perfect. This discussion and how the principles is important. And yes, transparency is one of the most important.
that sense, I think Greg things such as appropriate safeguards, redress, transparency are and move forward. And speaking of personal data protection, I think different countries have also adopted different mechanisms, different tools to enable data to be possible to identify perhaps two big groups of approaches. On one hand, decisions, standard contractual clauses, binding corporate rules, and on the other hand, different approaches based perhaps more on the idea of conduct. It's a very complex network of international data transfer mechanisms and to establish priorities considering their own specific circumstances, but also the specific remarks. I think perhaps an important way forward is for us to discuss issues Global Privacy Assembly, for instance, and I think perhaps for instance, that are enshrined both in domestic legislations but also international frameworks regarding the right to access, the right to correction, the right to opposition, the right to transparency. That were very nicely
Thank you, Miriam. Between the economic impact and also the human rights, we have to and also three mechanisms. Agencies. Great. We benefit the free. See, again, they are very have a united border data for itself.
Apologies accepted. Finnish is not common network operator. if you think about it, cross-border data transfer, so the networks that we have for channels for data. And so when we talk about data flows across borders, data that's important. No longer really only the operators who are responsible for the data. Also cloud service when we are talking about ecosystem and then, you know, developing the now that's our main the moment. So from your perspective, even information request concerning that or perhaps even blocking to the operator thing. So legally speaking, quite sound. And then what might be interesting as well, that operator standardized rule so I think that if we go back to the principle from our point of view things, and I think that the European legal framework, while there are always exceptions and maybe some loopholes, but by and large we are covering this quite well. So if third party, that's the and while we start to then that that private company would ideally have, and then you know taking this into further and taking to the EU is at the moment also in the process of reinforcing different in particular terms. So we have a new piece of regulation coming on. discussed. So these are different things that, you know, even further than what is maybe also interesting, that while the policy and in parallel. Cooperative practices between technical, if you like, even best coalition called have different, for example, and very but any international. Different regulatory and technical developments preserve agreement trying to and with respect to all the privacy concerns and respect to rights of citizens. Thank you very much.
And I would still there. And which is what is. So, Carolina, if
all the colleagues it was really interesting to hear both from the private sector in terms of instances and the difficulties and how sensitive is the data we are all talking about. Very clear to all of us on all that is and to balance based on some of the ICC principles. And I'm sure she's sharing this year, can see those principles as very balanced principles. So ensuring that who is accessing the data and for what. To access and also of course things are different, of course that is not law enforcement needs to act are less democratic, less
privacy. With the So thank you again, and we thank you. Mr. Iida-san, Yoichi Iida is coming in the room. After this short round table, maybe we have five speakers.
20 years ago? And so revealing. Other types of metadata. And do we get the analyzed and these brokers have the ability to flexible enough to account for new changes
that, and yes, I agree, and I am just imagining that the quantum computing will change the world totally so in the future. So the technology.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, we've that's going to be of filling them. So I accept that there are challenges in terms of these countries that are not seen as democracies. Data that was exported in terms of value of major sort of and we'll have a which was mentioned on the massive digital implore governments to look at coming up with, you know, based on what the ICC is doing and the OECD and other organizations, looking at working and trying. Have some kind of thinking a careful how you avoid that lowest common denominator. But this is we need help from government. Thank you.
My question, next question should be the, well, discussion about this issue. So, but it's not for now. Thank you. So, the future.
There does seem to be a path forward here with these ICC. Safeguards that should have framework. And oversight redress, these are all key. But I agree with Greg and Carolina that transparency must extend beyond transparency reports to to obtain each other's public sector data from third to address potential conflicts of law should they arise. And problem, as Peter said, that really cannot be a bilateral within the U.S. But, you know, I think the OECD effort suggests that a multi
you have wrapped up most of the things, and I will lose the job as a moderator. So thank you anyway. So okay. So yeah, the communication. Committee of the Digital Economy in Japan 2020 has many rules. How it will impact the governance of data and how it will benefit. The rule setting much appreciated.
kind introduction. And after listening to his introduction, I'm a little good afternoon. Other session? My previous speaker. Very much consistent with the previous discussions, please. The last few. As many of you, or maybe when we took the Pundi, but over the previous is marvelous. More economic growth, more social development activities on internet. So the people to join digital economy and make use of data without concern. So we country at wouldn't say a regulation, but we cannot use digital technologies without concern. Strengthen trust of people on data, digital economy, or even values to economy and freedom. Dichotomy. Work in a complementary way. The discussion on the trust among people and the digital technology without concern to interpretation, and I believe there are still different interpretations, emphasis on the concept, but countries, many government, private synergies And at OECD, there has been access to data held by private sector. Or objected to collect current practices on element. So this is a kind of a fact by country. Of Japan and probably many other countries understand the rules and regulations, technology or digital policy in general must be varied from country to country. Cultural backgrounds other factors. So we can achieve different government access practice is one of the such practices to strengthen the interoperability. Their personal data abused or looking to host next some multi-stakeholder discussion. would be one of the factors to even at G7 or G20, we are always and also in OECD, as ICC has been. We are also trying to pass a we try not only in IGF but also under G7, and we try to synergize the discussion continuous and invite all those speakers from different and take management data utilization. Next year, relations communities, and so please contact.
Or principles is very, very important to harmonize the regulation and while expecting the nations are facing differently. So thank you so much. And I apologize, we don't have the A time. In we have nicely discussed about it across both how this is a civil people, or yes, the here in this room, but versus growth and many things, and data utilization and the data protection is one of the things we have to take care of. So this is a very, very deep working on that with a multi-stakeholder approach, as Ian and many other speakers has mentioned. So the audience.
Keeping the door closed here for others not to come in for the next session.
Thank you so much. I think we are quite technology is being used to gave that there is someone doing some panic. So what we see in to Twitter can be veto mechanism that would allow or prohibit Twitter framework your recommendations about governments from spying on
So, all the distinguished panelists and the and the UN tech supports. And thank you very much. Have a nice day.